So I get asked a lot of times what DevOps is, how do we get started with it, what you could essentially do to learn it, and so on and so forth. So in this video, I'm gonna focus at extreme beginners who have no experience whatsoever with DevOps and want to get into this area, want to be able to call themselves that they are operating in DevOps team or anything like that. So let's get into it. Also, if you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon. It really helps. All right, so if you're new to DevOps, what you can think of DevOps is it basically integrates developers with the operation teams. And operation teams consist of like people like system administrators, whose responsibility is to make sure that the systems are stable, your web application or anything, your API endpoints are up and working, error logging is taking place. Yeah, you know, all that system related stuff. And developers are the people who are responsible for writing code, which is most probably you. Now, you might not have faced this as an individual indie developer, but what happens with bigger organizations is that once you have separate teams for development and separate team for deployment, that is your operations team, your system administrators and stuff, this creates a lot of delay. For example, you as a developer have written some code, you cannot directly push it to production without, you know, certain tests being checked, system administrators being checking whether they could deploy this code right now or not. Systems might go unstable, your website could go down if there is not proper checking of code, or maybe if the code just works on product on your development environment, not on production. So all these cases had to be handled earlier by the ops team. But DevOps, in a nutshell, handles it using certain automation tool. So in this video, let's see what are these tools which you can, as an indie developer as well, use and get started with. Number one is GitHub. You absolutely need to know how to work with GitHub or any other similar tool like GitLab or something. But you need to know how to work with Git in general, a version control system, which allows you to not only share your code with others, but pull their code, make changes, basically organize your flow as a developer inside your development team. In GitHub itself, you should be knowing about a bunch of tools, especially webhooks, which is a little bit related to DevOps, because this is where all that triggering and stuff happens. When you push your code to GitHub, this webhook is triggered and, you know, other tools then take place. So you should be aware about webhooks and stuff. If you have not ever heard about webhooks on GitHub, go ahead and give it a read. I would place Docker at number two, which is a very great tool to have inside your DevOps environment. Docker, in a nutshell, would allow you to make sure your development environment and your production environment are as close as possible, as well as gives advantage of sandboxing and stuff, which is amazing if you ask me. Docker is strictly not required for continuous development and deployment, but still, if you want to give it a try, it is no harm in 2019. Docker is the hot thing at the moment, and if you have got time, you should surely go ahead and learn it. As a beginner, I would also recommend you to pick up any one of Circle CI or Travis CI, which are some most popular continuous integration services available, and they are both free, so don't worry about that. Travis CI is, I guess, paid for private repositories, but Circle CI is free for that as well. So what continuous integration means is, just like we talked about GitHub webhooks, what happens is that when you push your code to GitHub, Circle CI would then kick in and would run some custom tests you have written against your code, and if those tests are passed, then your code is automatically deployed on production. If not, then GitHub would help you to fix those errors and would report you and all that stuff. So it's pretty powerful if you have an open source project where you are accepting pull requests from a lot of people. So Circle CI would automatically run all those tests against their commits and their pull requests and would cut down a lot of development time for you as well. I'm gonna also recommend you one of the tools, Google Cloud Platform or AWS. Just go ahead and use any one cloud service provider. Maybe if you want to use your own cloud service provider, maybe like DigitalOcean, that's fine. But what I want you to do is actually go ahead and set up your own server, not any Elastic Beanstalk or, you know, any preloaded app. I want you to SSH into a particular EC2 machine or maybe an instance you have created on Google Cloud and set it up completely all by yourself. Now, you're gonna need a lot of information about that, like setting up Nginx, you know, configuring your DNS records for making sure you are able to access it via domain name. You need to install Node, NPM, all that stuff which you want. You need to set up some firewalls if you want. You need to set up GitHub hooks, just we talked about. You need to set up deployment, automated deployment scripts. But that is how you would learn. Don't use those deploy automatic tools which automatically just where you just have to upload your zip file of your project and it would just serverlessly start your application and you're good to go. Don't do that. This way you would not learn. How you would learn is basically by creating your own server and basically configuring it from scratch down. Configure that server to pick up GitHub hooks, work with Travis or CircleCI, whatever you pick, and configure a little small automated deployment where you push your code to GitHub. It is automatically run against certain tests you have written and it's deployed automatically on whatever you choose, Google Cloud or AWS or whatever you want, right? So this way you're gonna get started with DevOps. Once you get started with it, you're gonna discover a little more sophisticated tools and better tools to make your job much more simpler, but that you would usually need on working with large scale servers or maybe large scale user base and something like that. So yeah, that's all for this video. If you liked it, don't forget to subscribe, press the bell icon and like the video. I'm gonna make some more videos on DevOps if I get good response on this one. So that's all for this one and I'll see you then in the next video.